Ornaments of the sky. Birds. Hello, friends. Oh, it's almost noon. I've been late this morning. Look, there are a lot of birds in the sky. You all must have wondered how birds can fly in the air. Many people have wondered this throughout history. Some of them studied for years and sought ways to fly. But this aim has only been achieved in this era. Still, we are the masters of flight. Now let's examine how some birds fly. Dear children, pigeons are probably the most commonly known kind of bird. Some of you may even have fed them. A pigeon first hops to take off. Once it is off the ground, it moves its wings up and pushes the air down as much as possible. Then, it does the same with all its strength. Slightly lying forward, it is now high enough to advance in the air. Can larger birds do the same? No. A large bird, for example, an albatross, cannot do it. But it uses a different method to fly. It speeds up over a long runway, and then it takes off. Aircrafts also use this method, which people have learned from albatrosses. For most of the birds, the weariest part of flight is the takeoff. Then, the bird can easily soar in the air. How is it that birds can fly in the air so easily without ever falling? Thanks to the perfect structure of their wings. Wings are created in a way that enables the most effective use of air currents. Some birds generate the air current that should be beneath their wings themselves. To do that, they flap their wings. Look at this bird, which looks like it is rowing in the air. When the wing is in an upward movement, half of the wing is folded inwards. When the wing is flapped downward, the bird extends its wing. With each movement, the feathers come closer together. In this way, although the shape of the wing may change at any moment, the lower part of the wing remains flat. God has created the ideal flight system for each bird in accordance with its requirements. Some birds fly for months, They feed and sleep in the air. We skillfully fly in the skies, but this doesn't mean that we are always airborne. Every flight has a landing at the end, doesn't it? Do you wonder how we do that? Then watch carefully. A safe landing is as important as takeoff. Birds are highly skilled in landing. This time, they use their wings in slow motion. This bird, called a puffin, can remain suspended in the air thanks to rising air currents. It also uses this talent while landing. An instant of carelessness may result in undesired consequences. Swans, which are among the birds with the largest wings, land on water using their feet as brakes. Flying is quite easy for us, but human beings need to manufacture aircrafts in order to fly. And this is a very hard thing to do. Many engineers work in order to make a plane.